How's it going, guys? I'm That One Asian Kid, and today we're going to be doing a playthrough of Clannad, a visual novel by VisualArts / Key Studios. And it is, it's a roller coaster. If you've never actually played through it or watched the anime, you're in for a surprise, to say the least. It is a very well-made series, without further ado, let's get into it. The world is covered in white. Snow. Yes, it's snow. Even now it continues to fall, coating me in its paleness. What could I be doing here? Better yet, how long have I been here? My hand is buried in snow. It's holding on to something. I pull it out. It's a pure white hand. A girl's hand. Oh, yeah, that's right. I wasn't alone. I wipe away the snow on her face. Her profile, sleeping peacefully, appears before me. Yes, this girl and I had always been together, here in this world. This empty, sorrowful world. Oh, I love this anime. Oh boy. I hate this town. There's just too many memories here I'd rather forget. Every day is the same. Go to school, see friends, come home to a place I can't stand. Nothing new ever happens. I wonder if anything will change if I keep living like this. I wonder if my life will ever change. There's nature almost everywhere you look around here. I guess today is just another day of trekking through the mountains to get to school. The trip would be so much easier if I could just level them all. If I were able to go in a straight line, I'd probably save myself 20 minutes. 20 minutes every day. How much time would that save me a year? I try to do the math in my head as I walk. I can't figure it out. I don't see any other students from my school around. This is the main street to school too. Normally there are students everywhere. Today isn't a vacation day or anything like that either. So I guess that means I'm late. Responsible students don't just stroll into school at this hour of the day after all. Still, I continue walking at a leisurely pace, unfazed by my realization and the deserted scene before me. 200 meters left to the school gates. I stand still for a moment. I exhale dejectedly while gazing up at the sky. There stand the school gates, all the way up to the ridge. Whose idea was it to put a school at the top of a giant slope anyway? This hill goes on like a never-ending nightmare. There's another sigh, but one much smaller and shorter than mine. I look to my right. A girl is standing there. Just as still as me. I can tell from the color of the school insignia on her uniform that she's also a third year student. But she isn't someone familiar to me. Her short hair, that comes to just above her shoulders, flutters in the wind. She seems to be on the verge of tears. As a repeat offender of late arrivals, I'm not bothered one bit. She, on the other hand, seems far more concerned. The idea of getting to class this late must be pretty upsetting to her. She's nodding her head up and down with her eyes closed, as if telling herself something. Then, she opens them. She stares up at the school gates. Huh? Oh, she's not asking me. She's talking to somebody else. Someone in her head, I guess. I wonder how he, or perhaps she, replied. She continues to talk to herself awkwardly.
それでもこの場所が好きでいられますか? 私は...
You just have to find more, that's it. The girl looks at me, surprised. It's almost as if she thought she was alone this whole time. Then you just have to find, you just have to find more things that are fun. More things that can make you happy. That's all. That can't be too hard, right? The expression on her face. Ah, yes. I remember those days. What it felt like to be naive, simple. That's something we've all experienced. Come on, let's go. We start to climb the hill. The long, long hill. April 14th, Monday.
Tsunohara.
The teacher calls a student's name.
Aikawarazuいないのか?
I look to my side where Tsunohara's desk sits empty. His attendance rate is even worse than mine. You see, the two of us are often labeled as the delinquents at school. But that's probably why we get along so well. He's really the only person in class I can have an honest conversation with. Nevertheless, today's classes begin. I spend them looking out the window. The teacher's voices go in one ear and out the other. Classes finish, bringing the school day to an end. Tsunohara never did show. In fact, the only person I've spoken to all day is that girl from this morning. It really is just another ordinary day. Since I'm not part of any after-school club, I grab my empty bag, cut through a pack of jabbering students, and leave the classroom. I could go home, but there wouldn't be anyone else there at this hour. Not anyone I'd want to see, anyway. I don't have a mother. I was told that she died in a car accident when I was still little. I don't even remember what she looks like. After her passing, my father sank into a pretty deep depression, probably due to the shock of it all, using alcohol to numb his pain. he wasted away his days gambling. Because of that, a lot of my time as a kid was spent arguing with him, actually. But one day, our relationship took a turn for the worse. He got violent with me. Ever since then, my father stopped showing his emotions. He's also stopped calling me just Tomoya, instead calling me Tomoya-kun, as if we're just more than strangers. And indeed, he's turned into just that at this point. It's like he's retreating into some kind of shell. As if he's trying to sever the present from the past. It'd be better if he just pushed me away completely. Or even just keep hitting me. At least then I'd know where I stand with him. But no, every time he sees me back home from school, he brightens up like an old friend is visiting and starts making small talk. It hurts. It hurts so much. I can't stand being at home anymore. That's why I stay out so late now. If I come home when I know he's asleep, I don't have to see him. It's why I go to bed at dawn. Of course, that I don't wake up till noon. I've been late almost every day since starting high school. I've spent my life like this for almost 3 years now. Today's no different either. I go home just to change out of my school uniform, then I leave again before my father gets back. The route practically feels ingrained in me at this point. I wander around town, aimlessly until nightfall. No matter what, I always end up at the same place. On my way, I grab some takeout from one of the local restaurants. I carry it with me as I walk down the massive hill from this morning toward the school dormitory. Our school pays special attention to its clubs, so a lot of students come from more rural areas to enroll. Those students then live here for the next 3 years, separated from their parents. These kids are practically members of a different species when compared to someone without any academic dreams like me. Normally, I wouldn't have anything to do with them, but Tsunahara lives here. He used to be on the soccer team and was even accepted to this school because of how good he was. However, he lost his spot on the varsity team as a freshman after being suspended for getting into a huge fight with a student from another school. By the time the following year's squad was decided, he was already an outcast within the team. He had no choice but to leave. He doesn't have the money to move though, so he still lives in the dorms where all the jocks are. Tsunahara is standing there. He's in front of another room, talking to a student about twice his size. Tsunahara hangs his head, still standing in front of the no closed door. He mumbles the words under his breath. He won't be able to hear you like that, you know. Damn it, stupid rugby players! Standing behind him, I repeat his words with a yell. I love this character, seriously. Tsunahara grabs my head and drags me into his room. I love Tsunahara, seriously. I just love everything about him. I can hear angry yells of, "Hey, who was that?" resonating from the hallway. You're the one who said it.
あのさ、岡崎。ただでさえここのところ 連中との関係が穏やかじゃなくなってるんだからさ。
So、let's go out with a bang.
あと1年残ってるよ。
And you're just going to live and feel like this the entire time?
あのね、僕だって一対一なら引くことはないさ。たけど、周りは全部ラグビー部の部屋。こんな場所でことを起こした日には、部が悪すぎるよ。でもまあ、卒業間際になったら派手にやるのもいいね。そん時は岡崎、僕の背中はお前に任せるぜ。
Great. I'll be sure to take a shot of my own at you while at it.
来るなよ、行けよ。
I'm on the rugby team side, you know.
いつからだよ。
Oh, not now, but I will be when all this goes down.
はい？なんでよ。共に過ごしてきた僕らの2年間は一体何よ？え？
The wall shakes. The rumble is followed by a quiet down. I'll kick the wall right back for you. You get scared way too easily. He's crying now. sure.His pathetic display has such an impact on me that I give in without thinking. I settle down in the small area between the wall and Tsunahara's ever-present katatsu table and begin to eat my dinner. Sorry, can I get some tea?
Dineyo!
Hey, I said sorry.
Adama sageyo ga deneyo!お前、ここが食堂かなんかと勘違いしてない？
We're in your room. I understand that.
ああ。
And you're my mate here.
全然わかってないっすね。
Please, I forgot to buy some.
自分で行くという発想は浮かばないのかよ。
But I thought you wanted to do anything you could to be of service to me after I saved your life, no?
そんな裏設定は隠されていません！
That's what you told me after I saved you, though. That man named Tsunahara died long ago. Before you now stands your loyal attendant. I am but a simple tea servant. That's what you'll say to me. So, tea please.
壮大な嘘つかな!
All right. Could you just get me one last cup of tea then?
最初も最後もねえよ!
Oh, but it's such a moving story.You'll definitely want to pour me some once you hear it. You seem done for, after suffering life-threatening injuries. But I, thirsty, ordered you to make me tea. So you summoned up the last drops of your strength to go brew some, even as you groveled on all fours. And then, Mr. Okazaki, here's your tea, sir. And this cup will be my last.You died with a smile on your face.
僕、むちゃくちゃ本望そうっすね。
Well, it was exactly how you'd wished it to go, after all. Nevertheless, I sat there, drinking that final cup of tea as I cried. See, moving, isn't it? So, tea please.
ディネってな!
I spent the rest of my time there reading a magazine.No TV in the room. The only things I can really do are talk to Tsunahara or read. It was late, and the date had already changed over. Yeah, I guess so. One line I didn't cross was staying the night at Tsunahara's room. Just the thought of waking up in the morning to someone like that is depressing.
じゃあ僕、シャワー浴びてくっから。
Okay.Tsunahara grabbed some underwear and a towel out from under a heap of clothes in the corner of his room before leaving. I prefer to avoid having to welcome Tsunahara back to his room after a shower, so I'll leave while I still can. I close the magazine and get up off the floor. As I do, I find myself looking at a cassette player. There's a tape still sitting in it. I try playing it. Out comes the melody of a Japanese rap song that hasn't been popular for a while. Talk about lame. Who listens to this kind of stuff? Ooh. I'll just record my own voice over it. Alright, I'll dub my own rap over it instead. I'll call it a rap dedicated to my close friend, Tsunahara. Oh. I can just imagine him being moved to tears by it. Here we go. I take a deep breath and press the record button. Yo, yo, my name is Okazaki. You're... I string the words together at a good tempo. But then, I can't think of anything else to say. Forget it. It's stupid. I quickly get discouraged. Why am I doing this for him? Considering our relationship, you probably couldn't even call us super close friends to begin with. I should just get going. I decide to leave before Tsunahara returns. April 15th, Tuesday. Oh, I'm seeing Nagisa again! No! But the episode's been 20 minutes long, and I think we're gonna end it off right here. Oh, and it's just getting to Nagisa. Damn. Well, alright. Oh. Yeah, I'm gonna end the video off here. If you like the video, or if you just like Clannad, or if you will enjoy the series, enjoy the video, leave a comment, like, subscribe, share it. Yeah, I'm super excited to keep recording this series. Like, I love the characters, I love Clannad. Yeah. But, yeah, at the end of the day, I'm still that one Asian kid. Signing out. Bye-bye!